to the tallest Congress leaders, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel's birth anniversary, Bharat Ratna Srimati Indira Gandhiji's death anniversary. It's a shameful on the part of the Prime Minister. One should not play politics on legacy of national icons. We hope, at least on this day, the state which he comes from, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel ji's, we are Japan to Prime Minister, let's not diminish, derogate, humiliate national icons who laid their life for this country. Unfortunately, neither the Prime Minister nor has a role in the national independence struggle nor India's building of modern India. Today, an historical day. Normally in politics, never seen an incident like this where a ruling party at the national NDA, Telugu Desam Party, in Andhra Pradesh and at the center, they are in power. The working president of the Telugu Desam Party from Telangana state, an young leader, an energetic leader, Sri Revanth Reddy, who is a working president of Telangana state, not only keeping up the high moral values, resigning from his seat and joining today, believing in Congress ideology, in the presence of Honorable Sri Rahul Gandhiji, the Vice President of the Congress Party, along with other senior leaders. He joined today along with the 20 and odd other, our Congress State President, Sri Uttam Kumar Reddy ji, and our Congress Honorable General Secretary in charge of Telangana, Sri R.C. Kuntia ji, will explain to you. But quickly, today the many of ex-MLAs, MLCs, ministers, district presidents, about 5 ex-MLAs, ex-MLCs 1, senior office bearers of TDP 7, TRS leaders 2, and particularly the, if you recollect the Telangana movement led by the Usmania University Joint Action Committee, the Students Committee. Today, 3 of the prominent Joint Action Committee leaders, Daru Yellanna, Bala Lakshmi, Bhaskar, Durgam Bhaskar, 3 of them also joining the Congress Party today. What I started today, it is very historical because Congress Party in opposition in the center and the state, but the ruling Telugu Desam Party at center and Andhra Pradesh state are joining Congress means it's a time for the people of Telangana. It is the Congress Party, our Honorable President Srimati Sonia Gandhiji, honoring the word. Congress always sticks its word and see the sacrifice of the people of Telangana. Many youth have laid their life, given the Telangana, but the people of Telangana trusted the Chandrasekhar Rao government and given a power. But in the past 3.5 years, the undemocratic, the utterly corrupt government, then led by Chandrasekhar Rao, seen the 3,400 farmers committing suicides. The wishes of the people who martyred not only not fulfilled, the youth of Telangana left with no jobs. And it is a TRS government which is supporting, as our leader, Sri Rahul ji said it, the Modi at the center and Chota Modi, who is known as Chandrasekhar Rao, Uruf KCR. The CAG has reported how corrupt the government is, how the Mission Kakatiya and other projects of launched by the TRS government, not only state gone into debt, but the corrupt practice which they're indulging. And we will welcome the leaders of the Telugu Desam.
Priya Nayak, a very active tribal leader who contested the MLA last time. Mr. Billia Nayak, who is the president of the Telugu Desam Party for Nalgonda district. Mr. Rajaram Yadav, who is a very active student leader and state spokesperson of the Telugu Desam Party. Mr. Ramesh Reddy, who is the president of the Suryapet district Telugu Desam Party. Mr. Vijay Ramana Rao, who is a former MLA and present president of the Pedapalli district of Telugu Desam Party. Along with them, from the ruling party, TRS party, Mr. D. Sambaya, who is the MP contested candidate from the Warangal MP seat. Along with them from the Usmania University, which was the hotbed of the Telangana movement, the entire Telangana movement was fueled from the Usmania University students. The students who led the movement for the Telangana creation of a separate Telangana state and formed what is popularly known in Telangana is as the Usmania University Joint Action Committee. Shri Daru Yellanna, Srimati Bala Lakshmi, and Shri Durgam Bhaskar have also joined the Congress Party today in the presence of the Honorable Vice President Shri Rahul Gandhiji. On behalf of Congress Party, there are many other names which I don't want to take your time and read it out. We can give you a note separately. Now I request... I now request Mr. Revanth Reddy, who was still recently the working president of the Telugu Desam Party in Telangana state, and the floor leader in the assembly, he will speak. Before that, our Congress Party in charge, Dr. R.C. Kuntia, will briefly introduce the subject.
Sabhi ko dhanyabad. Main pehle aaj ki jo Srimati Indira Gandhi ki jo Shahid Divas hai unke liye homage and also the ex-home minister Sardar Patel unke liye bhi hamara taraf se AICC ki taraf se उनको आज का दिन में होमेज प्रदर्शन करता हूं और आज जैसे शुरू हुआ है आप लोगों को यह कहने के लिए खुशी होती है कि केंद्र में बीजेपी सरकार होते हुए और तेलंगाना में केसीआर सरकार आंध्रा में टीडीपी का सरकार होते हुए भी सीटिंग एमएलए फ्लोर लीडर एंड वन यंग डायनामिक लीडर रेवंत रेड्डी गारू जैसे लीडर और उनका साथ 14 एक्स मिनिस्टर एक्स एमएलए टीडीपी और टीआरएस को छोड़ के कांग्रेस में ज्वाइन हुआ है एक यूनिक थिंग है यूनिक थिंग ऐसे है वो तो बोलेंगे मगर सबसे बड़ा यूनिक ये है क्यों ज्वाइन किए टीडीपी में सरकार है आंध्रा में केसीआर में सरकार है जैसे बोल रहे थे कि तेलंगाना में कांग्रेस सरकार सोनिया गांधी तेलंगाना राष्ट्र गठन करने के लिए पार्लियामेंट में बिल पास करके राष्ट्र गठन करने के लिए तेलंगाना राज्य दिए हैं फिर भी केसीआर में सरकार में आए और केसीआर तेलंगाना में सरकार में रहने का बाद जो एश्योरेंस दिए थे फार्मर्स को स्टूडेंट को यूथ को ये अभी तक पूरा नहीं हो रहा सबको ज्वाइन कराना इसलिए जो आज ज्वाइन कर नहीं पाए हम सभी को पीसीसी में और फिर राहुल गांधी भी जब प्रोग्राम होगा तेलंगाना में वो ज्वाइन करेंगे तो जो आज राहुल गांधी का साथ ज्वाइन किए हैं वो नाम
उत्तम रेड्डी कुमार रेड्डी गारू पाठ किया है वो लोगों को फिर दोबारा हम स्वागत करते हैं
बाय द गवर्नमेंट हुज डिफाइनिंग फीचर इज इंटॉलरेंस टू एनी फॉर्म ऑफ डिसेंट थ्रू द गवर्नमेंट एनफोर्स इट अंडर द ग्रैब ऑफ एन ऑर्डर बाय द नेशनल ग्रीन ट्रिब्यूनल द कंट्री नोज द रियल रीजन फॉर द लासिटी विथ विच द आइकॉनिक प्रोटेस्ट साइट वॉज क्लीनड अप यस्टरडे We hope the nation will analyze whether the noise pollution at Jantar Mantar was a bigger threat to environment than this government's intolerance to democracy. We believe addressing the environmental concerns cannot be in conflict with the fundamental tenets of the people of the people's democratic rights. Political parties have various avenues of expressing dissent and the crackdown on Jantar Mantar is an assault on the ordinary people's right to protest and express their dissent against the government. In democracy, nothing can override the people's freedom to freely express their opinion. Jantar Mantar, with its strategic location, is the heart of the national capital and adjacent to parliament, the greatest temple of democracy accorded a significance of power to people's voices. It is not a coincidence that anti-democratic developments has happened under the Narendra Modi government in which the union cabinet and senior ministers and members of parliament have no voice. A prime minister who has achieved the rare distinction of denigrating all institutional powers within a short span of time, be it the cabinet or the Reserve Bank or Parliament or Election Commission. How can he protect the people's space that Jantar Mantar provided for decades? The mask of nationalism peeled off yet again yesterday when the Modi government used Delhi police to forcibly evict peaceful ex-servicemen, war veterans and war widows from Jantar Mantar and even arrested them thereafter. The Modi government did nothing to fulfill valid demands of one rank, one pension by ex-servicemen is now resorting to use brute force against them. Prime Minister Shri Modi celebrates Diwali with our army men but commits gross injustice with the same people just after Deepavali by denying them the benefits of ORoP. Since 870 days, now war veterans are forced to sit in protest to demand their pay parity. Time and again, Modi government has used brute force on war veterans. First, they used police force to evict lathi charge them on Independence Day 2015. Then, an ex-serviceman was forced to commit suicide in November 2016 and now is hiding behind the NGT order to target them. Crashing dissent, strangulating voices and silencing democracy has become the chief hallmark of the BJP. It is high time that the Modi government realizes the constitutional and democratic duties. Friends, I read out the text of what I was, because there is an issue of time. But these are serious issues. Jantar Mantar reflected the voice of the people. By evicting these voices, what you have done to democracy is under the NGT cover. What is the pollution that affects these people at the places who think that by doing this, they are controlling? They cannot take dissent. And that's precisely the issue. None in the, at least in the political parties, none of them have expressed his opinion. But we today demand an explanation from the government of why under the cover of NGT they've taken this step. Till now the other location was the boat club. Because of a law and order situation and variety of other reasons, they moved it to Jantar Mantar. Now what is it that bugs this government to remove disconnect democratic protests from that location? If it is the duty of the municipality and the government to clean up the place, if that is a problem. But where is the pollution there? These are issues of serious democratic values that are, and they are Congress leaders. Let there be no misunderstanding about it. Any other?